So it has happened to me as well. Some hacker has hacked my Google account as well. And of course, through my Google account, they've also hacked and taken over my YouTube channel, which is this very channel over here. So how did I get through it? How did I manage to recover all this? And how did I stop them from getting into more of my personal details and more of my accounts? So let me take you through all that step by step. Right, so the first thing, how did they manage to hack my account? Now they've got so many various ways of doing this, but some of the more obvious ways is they usually do send an email with a certain type of link, offering some kind of a deal or a partnership or an association or a collaboration of some sort, and they do attach a link, and obviously the link is not real. Now, obviously, most times you can catch this quick enough and you can stop this from happening, but ever so now and then, they do manage to sneak through on one way or the other. And I'm guessing I have a link somewhere. I'm not entirely sure where, but I'm thinking I had a link somewhere that was infiltrated. So, first thing, those of you that's been through this before knows that if you are or if you're on Google or on YouTube and you do realize that your account has been hacked or someone has tried to access your account that was not you, you get a notification and it gives you the option to say that it was not you and you want to do something about it. But in certain cases, this is often too late and they've already changed all your information and there's nothing you can do about it. Even if you select the option to change your password or anything of that, because they've already changed the two-step verification on your Google account. They've changed the email address. They've changed the verification phone number. In other words, it's on a different phone now, so you've got no more access. Even if you've got the personal questions or the private or the security questions, all of those are usually changed at this stage. But it does not hurt. As soon as you realize that your account has been compromised, try to recover it through that process by answering as many of the questions that they give you. It cannot get worse from there. You can only try to recover it. If you are quick enough, you might be able to catch them while they are still trying to change your password, and you can save your password or your account in time. Should that not be the case, and you are now completely locked out. Now, a lot of people prior to me or prior to this time have tried to recover their accounts, and many have failed, unfortunately, because the method is not quite as clear as to what to do, unfortunately. Now, a lot of people do click on the option recover account, and if you cannot get past the account verification, which usually requires your email address, your Gmail address, which is the one that is being compromised, and then obviously your password, which has been changed, the two-step verification, which details have been changed as well then by the hackers. In other words, given a different password, given a different verification cell phone number, given a different backup or recovery email address. So you therefore have no more access to your account whatsoever. So what do you do from there? Because this is usually the point where a lot of people hang up the towel after a while, because to get hold of Google is not that simple. It's not like you can pick up the phone Google and say, listen, I am so and so, and I want to recover my account that's been hacked. It is not that easy at all. So what method do you need to follow? Now, strangely enough, the easiest methods to get in touch with Google or YouTube in this case, which is one of the same basically, is through Twitter, or as it's nowadays called X, which is very strange. I mean, why is it this way? Who knows? But that is one of the quickest ways to get in touch with them. Obviously, you have first tried to recover your account through YouTube's or Google's steps that they've provided you. But that usually does not work if your account has already been compromised and your password has been changed. So, if you go on to Twitter or X, you need to look for Team YouTube. I'll put a screenshot of their X page or your Twitter page on the screen here. I'm not going to attach a link or any of that, so there's no funny business. You can see what the account looks like. It's Team YouTube. So, follow them on X, and then once you have followed them, instantly write them a message. On their page, it doesn't have to be an inbox or a direct message or a digital private message, anything. You can just comment on their page. Hello. Don't give any personal information on the public page. Just say, hello, my Google account has been hacked. Can you please assist me? and they usually respond fairly quick. My response was within an hour, and that is quite quick because this whole process, some people have reported the whole recovery process to take up to 48 hours. Some people have said a week. I was lucky enough to have had a shorter time, but we'll get back to that a bit later in the video. So if they respond already, they respond to your request, you just need to provide them the information that they require in a digital message or a DM basically. So it's going to be a bit more private and not for everybody to see on your wall. So only once they send you a DM, you can respond on that DM and give them all the information that they need. And that is the first step. Now, this does take time for them to check everything and go. They will, of course, provide you the same link at first, trying to recover it with the two-step verification and your security questions and so on. But if that fails, they have to do this. This is unfortunately procedure. But if that fails and that does not work, you can take it further because you're actually speaking to someone then on the X or the Twitter page instead of an automated system or a robot or AI robot. Now, while you have submitted your request and you're waiting for returns, the next thing that you need to do is you need to change as many of the passwords of the accounts associated to your Google account. And this also includes your Microsoft account of your PC or your Mac, whichever it may be. If something is associated with a Google account, try and log into those accounts and change your passwords because they would probably most likely have access to all those accounts. And that can be very problematic, especially if it's any financial accounts, whether it be crypto or Venmo or banking details. Try and change as many of them as possible. Like I said, including your Microsoft account. On your Windows PC or Mac PC or whatever it may be. So after you have done this on X or on Twitter,
on to Google,
and you need to log out of your old account. You need to delete that username for the time being, and you need to set up a new Google account with a new email address, a Gmail address, and a new password. It's completely separate of the old one that has now been compromised. You need to do this in order for Google to contact you and for you to enter Google or to sign into Google, if I can put it that way. Now, once you have done that, you've set up a new Google account, just go to the Google homepage and create new account. What you then need to do is you need to go to the normal Google search page or the Google homepage and type Google support or Google help. Well, you type on Google help on the selections or on the list that's been thrown out, and then in the box at the top that says describe your issue, you must type account hacked or my account hacked, and then click on the appropriate option from the drop down list, which says whatever the case may be. But yeah, like you can see here, then click on the option. Once you've done that, scroll down to the first help article that is about your problem and click on that help article. On the next page there, you'll click on the link that refers to you being locked out of your account. You'll see that all on the screen right here. And then on the account recovery page, type in the Gmail address or the email address that was compromised. Once you've done that, it's going to take you to the next page and fill in all the information that they request. Now, part of or among all this information, you will also need your, or you might also need your channel ID and your channel handle. Now, to get these, you can go to YouTube. You don't have to log in as a user, as unregistered, or on your new account, you can just log into YouTube and then look for your channel. Basically, type in your channel name in the search bar, click on filters, and then just select channel. And then you can look for your own channel. Click on your own channel. And once you've got that, under your channel name, you'll see your channel handle. And then you'll see the about section as well. And then next to the about section is a more button. Click on that more button. And once you've clicked on the more button, scroll down to the share channel button or link at the bottom and click on that link. And then select share channel. This will show you your channel's URL and you can click copy next to it to copy it basically. Then paste this in a text document somewhere on your PC, on your homepage, your desktop or somewhere. You can also copy and paste your channel ID from here as well, just below that. And then if you go a bit up under channel details, you will also be able to see your channel handle. Okay, so now that you've got all these details, you can go back to the channel recovery page. Along with the URL, you can also put in any other information that they might request, like the previous info before it was changed by the hackers, like for instance, your verification phone number, what it used to be, or your old recovery email address, what that also used to be. And once you've submitted all of this information, you just have to wait for a recovery link from Google in order to change your password again. And once you've been able to change your password, you need to renew your two-step verification. You need to renew your verification phone number, change that back to what it needs to be, your own phone number, and change your recovery email address to what that needs to be. For all of that, to make your account secure again so that no one else has access to it. Once again, this can all take time, and you'll probably go through a couple of steps more than once. Like the recovery page, they usually try to do the same thing first of all. And ask your email address, ask your password. If you don't have the password, then they're going to go through all the security questions again. If you do not get that, then only will they give you the option to enter things like the URL of your channel and the previous information and all those type of things. And once you've submitted, you have to wait until you get a response from someone at Google or YouTube containing the reset your password link. And once you've got the reset your password link, then you can start fresh. Now, once you've changed your password and you've changed your two-step verification and all the security parameters, then you need to go back to your channel and you need to change everything back on your channel to the way it was. If they have deleted some of your content and so on that you cannot recover or you do not have anymore, you can request that from YouTube as well and state them, listen, since my account was hacked, it's now recovered. I need to restore it to a certain date, whether it be the day before or whatever, so that YouTube can restore your account to all that. If it's minor changes like a thumbnail or description or something like that, that is something you can just change yourself back, and it's usually quite quick. Something to check as well is on your AdSense account, if you have one, double check the information on that. Thank your banking details or your payment details have not been changed. And then also check your passwords there as well, because once again, that is linked to your Google account and they probably did have access to it. On my account, they changed the picture, the thumbnail and everything to this. I'll show you a picture on screen now as well. And even though the thumbnail and the background is different, the links, they have not changed yet. If you look carefully, you'll see that the links are still the links for my old channel on my old channel name. So either this was at a stage where they have not yet managed to change everything and I got lucky. The plan is usually they delete your content, and the thumbnail and background that they use is not necessarily something original of their own. Like the ones used on my channel while it was hacked is a much larger channel with many more subscribers. So this is one of their tactics. They take a channel that is monetized with not quite as big an audience yet, and then they try to copy or imitate a much larger channel with many more users or subscribers. And they want to fool people thinking that is the same channel and obviously draw subscribers, draw views and make money through that. Obviously, they will also try and change the AdSense details. They'll try to change the banking details. So it is quite a headache. Otherwise, they might only put infectious links on your page or on your channel, causing people to get infections on their computers or phones, and obviously giving the hackers access to their info as well. And in the long run, this is all about money. They usually hack your account like they did with mine. They probably, once they've hacked it, they sell your channel to someone, the hackers now. They do not necessarily do it themselves. Someone buys your channel and then do whatever they want on it further. Give me a comment in the comment section below telling me what happened to you, or if you've got any other useful tips of how to get out of this, please leave that in the link below as well. It can be very useful. Now, for myself, from when I found out that I was hacked up until where I was able to do a full recovery was just under 10 hours. So I was extremely lucky. There obviously probably were cases in the past where someone has taken less time to get through a recovery. But unfortunately, there's been cases where it has taken a lot longer as well. So I'm very grateful. It is over. I have recovered my account, my Google account, and my YouTube account. And my channel is now back to the way it was. So once again, if you liked it, thumbs up, like this video, and also subscribe to the channel now that it's back to normal. Thank you very much, guys.